Hi, I'm Annelieke and I'm the research lead here at Yoast. And in this screencast, I'm going to show you how you can create your own Google Data Studio dashboard so you can analyze your pages and posts and share them with your team members and know how to optimize them.
Curious to see how you can create your own Google Data Studio dashboard? Here we go. And the first thing I'd like is for you to use Google Analytics demo account. So if you just go to Google and search for Google Analytics demo account, you can see here in the second, it's my second result, a way to access the demo account of Google Analytics. It will take you to its e-commerce website. And when clicking on this, you can have access to it. And you can see here in one master view in the Google merchandise store. So this is very cool, this demo account, because you can see how an actual Google Analytics account works and you can test all things yourself. And the cool thing is that you can use this analytics account to create dashboards and just play with dashboards using Google Analytics demo account. So let's head back to Google Data Studio because we're gonna make an awesome dashboard using this demo account. So the first thing you need to do is here, the big plus, is start a new report. Now, you can see something like this. And you can add here at your right a data source, and because I'm already using Data Studio, I see a lot of data sources here, but you can create a new data source here. And you see all possible Google connectors, so all possible things you can add to your Google Data Studio. So here's an Ad Manager, Google Ads, Google Analytics, Google Sheets, Google Search Console, you know, a lot of interesting things you can do and connect with in Google Data Studio. So today it's Google Analytics, so I just press select, and as you can see here, I want the demo account of the Google merchandise store and I want the master view. It's as simple as that. Click on connect and it will show you all dimensions and metrics Google Analytics has to offer. It's sometimes very interesting just to scroll down these dimensions and metrics because you can then see what's available. But that will take a bit too long for this screencast. So I'm just going to press this blue button that says Add to Report. Here we go. Yes, I want to do this. So Add to Report. And here we are. We have a clean sheet of things where we can create beautiful things. When I think about dashboards, I think about things I want to show, I want to see for myself. So I usually pull out a piece of paper and a pen and just start drawing things I'd like to see. So here's an example of a dashboard, of the dashboards we're gonna make today. So the goal of my dashboard is to find out where traffic is coming from. And I'm thinking about a table, a pie chart, map of the region, date range, some things I can, you know, compare it from this week with last week or the week before. So this is a kind of thing I want to build for myself in Google Data Studio. So let's get back to the untitled report. Well, let's add a title. And I call it Traffic Sources. Now, as you can see here, there are a lot of options. And just take your time, hover all the options just to see what it is. And because I use it fairly often, I know what everything is. And I always start with adding a date range. So I clicked here and I selected the date range. And at the right-hand side, you can alter just specify the things you'd like to see. So for instance, I can tell this date range that I always want to see the last week and that it starts on Monday. So I hit apply. And that's my first step. Always my first step is to add the date range. And now I want to see more. I want to see a table. So I go to not the date range, not the filter, but I'd like to add a chart and just a simple table. Now, if you click on it, it will, you know, present you this medium and page views. And that's not really what I like. So I'm gonna, you know, gonna specify this with things I'd like to see. So I'm just gonna broaden it because I'm gonna add more columns to this table. And here on your right hand, you can see the dimensions and the metrics. And you can just click on it and think about, well, I want to see landing pages. And then just use the search option to find the dimension landing page. And here it is in my table already. And I actually want to recreate the landing page report in from Google Analytics. So I need to go to behavior. And the reason I do this, I want to check how Google handles this, is because with landing pages, there are sessions. And here you see it got me page views. But that's not the good way of handling page views, or you cannot combine landing pages with page views. You can only combine landing pages with sessions, and that has to do with the way Google Analytics stores its data. So I'm just gonna see here, okay, sessions, what kind of dimension or what kind of metrics would I like to see? Sessions, bounce rate, pages per session, transactions, revenue, e-commerce, conversion rate. So I'm just gonna add this. But since, you know, we're talking traffic sources, this isn't telling me anything about traffic sources. So I'm gonna add a dimension, which is, I want to know the source. So here I can add more dimensions. And if I'd like, I can also add campaign as another metric of a dimension. And check, here it is. But as you can see, in this case, it's not very interesting. So I'll just remove it. Then I'll use sessions instead of page views. I want bounce rate. I want pages per session. I want transactions. I also like to see the e-commerce conversion rate and revenue. Yes, let's look it up. Here we go. Yes, here we are. Now you can, you know, adjust this to see where all the traffic is coming from, how many sessions there are, the bounce rate. You know, and if you don't like these little dots, you know, you can, also add a summary row. So you have a grand total. And here with style, you can actually, customize the table you're seeing. So I want to wrap the text so I know, and I don't like this being 3, call me OCD, but it's just how I roll. So I want to do this. Ah, yes, that's much better. So I here now have the landing pages, and I know the source. So I can see that most of my visitors that come on the homepage come from Google, and a part comes from Google's email, I guess. Now, a cool thing here as well is that you can add a heat map. And with a heat map, you can quickly see which things stand out and which things don't. For instance, the bounce rate, which you can see here as the second column of the of metrics. Here you see metrics. Column 1 is sessions. Column 2 is bounce rate. And I can, instead of number, I can say heat map. And then you can see, ooh, this one stands out, like the partners has a higher bounce rate than others. So this can, you know, be a very quick visualization of things that stand out positively or negatively. So I think I'm pretty pleased with my table here. Let's check what my drawing wants me. Oh yes, a map of the region. That's also a very cool thing. When you add a chart, you know, here are all possible options. I can add a pie, a line, scatter, pivot table, bullet, and also a geo map. Now that's awesome. Here we go. And as you can see, the United States is where the most page views come from. But what if I want to see it not on country level, but on region level? Well, here we go. We can do that as well. And here you can immediately see that this state is a very popular state. And you can also think, well, I don't want page views. I want revenue. Here we go. You know, that alters a bit. But since it's about traffic sources, we are more interested in sessions. It's not an e-commerce dashboard we're building here. Now, I'm also interested in the number of people that come from a desktop and the number of people that come from a mobile device. So I think I can quickly see this by adding a pie chart. Here we go. Very nice pie chart, but it's on page views and medium, and I don't want that. I want device category, and I want it on a session-based level. And here we go. Well, that's interesting. Most of the traffic comes from a desktop. Cool. Also, great things to do is, add more pie charts from all traffic sources, because it's immediately clear what the biggest traffic source is. So I'll just make it smaller. You know, if you'd like, you can make the sheet bigger by just clicking on the sheet and, you know, make it larger or wider, and you have more space and more room. So here it's, let me just enhance it a bit. I want sources, and again on a session level. And then it's also immediately, you can see that Google is the biggest traffic source for this Google demo account. You can also add scorecards, like, let me check where they are. Here they are, like this one. It's a bit large, so I'll just... I can see page views. Well, again, let me just do sessions, but page views is very well. And the cool thing here is that you can, with all things, you can do a comparison with date range. But here, the cool thing is that I want to do it with the previous period. Apply. And then you can see this here, this little bit here. And it says if the number is declined or increased in comparison to the same period before. So that's very interesting. And well, you can copy paste it and say, okay, I want the same. And I'm actually also interested in the revenue. Here we go. Check if we have more. Ah, we had more revenue on this demo account. That's cool. Now, and for me, the really cool thing is not only that you have this all in one place, but that you can add filters very easily with the filter control. So here we go. We can do medium. Let me just make it a bit smaller. We can do... just make it source. And just quickly change this to sessions. And this one as well. Let me just copy this one and paste it. And for instance, make this campaign. Here we go. And now the cool thing is that if you hit, because you know, this is where you alter things, this is where you specify and create your dashboard. But when you look, when you press the view button, here it is, how the dashboard actually looks. And the cool thing with these filters is that you can say, well, I just want to see traffic. Let me just, maybe I'm too impatient. It's from organic. And it will show me only organic. Like Google is by far the biggest search engine, which isn't that surprising. And that's the cool thing, because you know, it's really dynamic. And another cool thing is that you can share this report with your colleagues or people of, you know, you think want to see this awesome dashboard. And here you go. This is an awesome dashboard that you can use for yourself and you can recreate it. So good luck.
So now in this screencast, you've learned how to create your own dashboard. And as you can see, it's not that hard. So good luck and try it yourself. You can do it.